I'm excited about what we have to do in 25. We have the team and the resources to execute the plan, and we will do that.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Scancell CEO Phillip L’Huillier. Phil, very good to speak with you today. Can you chat me through the highlights of Scancell's interim results?
Yes, good morning, Stephen, and thank you for that question. I think I would mention five highlights to summarize our highlights over the last half year. First of all, of course, there's the data from the SCOPE study, which we disclosed end of last year. And that data really is very compelling data that is showing benefit to the patients and a potential product that could be game-changing going forward. You might remember that the study is being conducted in third and fourth line stage melanoma, and we're giving patients our vaccine in combination with standard of care, the double checkpoints, ipilimumab and nivolumab. And the data, interim data at 25 weeks for 25 patients, so not the full study yet, but that showed a disease control rate of 80%. That means 8 out of 10 patients on the study received a benefit from the therapy, which is really very compelling data. On top of that, where we measured tumor reduction, we saw a 72% overall response rate. So 72% of the patients saw a significant reduction in their tumors, which again is really significant. And what we know is the standard of care today, the therapies available today, it's less than half show that tumor reduction, about 48%. So again, a large margin over standard of care. And then finally, progression-free survival was at 80%. And that's a measure of the longer-term benefit of the therapy. And again, a significant benchmark above what's currently available. So really compelling results for that product from those patients. The second point I would mention is the recruitment rate in our studies, both the SCOPE study, but also the Modify study with our Modi-1 product. Patients are coming forward and recruitment is progressing very, very well. So we'll see a number of clinical readouts over 25. The third highlight I would mention is an additional license with Genmab from our antibody portfolio. So additional industry validation, what we're doing is meaningful to industry. Fourthly, the financing that we closed at the end of 24. We raised 11.3 million, which gives us good funds to move through the clinic with our lead products in 25. And the final fifth highlight I'd mention is just the organizational change. In mid-24, we brought on board Nameen Varawalla, our new CMO, Chief Medical Officer, who brings a background in late stage development. And also, of course, I joined the company in mid-November, so strengthening the commercial but also clinical leadership. And that's also enabled Lindy Durrant to move back to the CSO role. And I see increasingly Lindy smiling as she's digging into data and working on science. So that's a great fit for us as well.
Bill, you mentioned the recent fundraise. What's your cash runway?
We've now got cash with the plan that we're executing in 25 through to the second half of 26.
And some of the key milestones which Scancell is hoping to achieve in 2025?
Yes, milestones in both the SCOPE study and the Modify study. Perhaps the first to mention is with the SCIB1 arm of the SCOPE study. By about mid-year, we'll have the full data set for the 43 patients in that arm of the study. That arm is now fully recruited, and we expect data around mid-year from that arm of the study. And then the next gen product, iSCIB1 Plus, data comes out through 25 for that arm of the study also. So over 25, there's several data readouts for the SCOPE study. But on top of that, we see readouts coming from the Modify study. We just announced that the Modi-1 product had reached its non-futility, showed some efficacy in the first stage of the head and neck arm of the study. And so that study has moved to the next phase of the study to recruit further patients. and that arm will read out along with the renal arm of the modify study through 25. In the second half of 25, we'll have data coming out of that study.
Phil, what are the key benefits of Scancell's non-personalized vaccines?
That's a very good question, Stephen. I would classify the benefits in three areas. First of all, there's the product itself. And a key benefit there is it's an off-the-shelf vaccine. So that means it's straightforward to manufacture. It's relatively low cost to manufacture, but it can also be made available quickly to patients. The second area of benefit is in the clinic. We are seeing really compelling results for the vaccine in combination with the double checkpoints. But on top of that, when we add our vaccine on top of the double checkpoints, we are not seeing any additional safety issues. So it's a very benign safety profile, as I call it, and can be added to other therapies. And then third benefit is there's a dual mechanism of action. So the way the vaccine works in the case of the SCIB vaccine, it's a dual mechanism of action, which means it acts on the immune system in a way that is more effective, but also provides longer-term immune control of the tumor.
Finally, Phil, you mentioned you were recently appointed as CEO of Scancell. What excites you most about the company's potential?
I'm delighted to have joined Scancell in November, and I think I've hit the ground running. What I see is really compelling products with excellent data emerging, and a very, very strong team in the organization, a deep immunology and translational medicine expertise, and that's foundational to be able to move forward such complex products in difficult diseases. Finally, there's also a strongly committed board and investors that have backed the company in the last round and in many rounds previously. So strong commitment from existing and new investors. I'm excited about what we have to do in 25. We have the team and the resources to execute the plan, and we will do that.
Look forward to more conversations with you as the year progresses. Thank you very much for your time today, Phil.
Thank you, Stephen.
That's Scancell CEO Phillip L’Huillier.